morning, everybody, and welcome to this week's Yoga Flow. So we're starting on the floor today. We're going to be predominantly floor-based for this session today anyway. So it's a kind of rest and digest the different poses that we're going to be doing today, okay? So sit up nice and tall. Just let your hands rest on the inside, on top of your thighs with your palms open. So that gives us a hand mudra to be ready to receive. So to receive whatever comes your way in your body, your mind, your breath. So just be open to receive what the body presents to you. So just allow your eyes to flutter closed. And then just take this time just to observe your natural breath, the natural rhythm of your breath, how you feel. You can place your left hand on your heart and your right hand on your belly. And then just feel that breath now. Are you breathing into both hands or just one? And then make a conscious effort to breathe a little deeper, fill your spaces, and then exhale, long, slow breath out. As you bring your mind to your intention for your practice today, just reaffirm that to yourself. As you maybe find some of the poses a bit challenging, define why you're here on your mat today. So allow your eyes to open. Let's take a breath in and bring it down. Take a breath in and bring it down. Take a breath in and bring it down. Okay, so I'm going to bend to the right side. And then come up and take a rotation to the left. So bend to the right, and rotate to the left. Bend to the right, rotate to the left. Do that on the other side now. So we bend to the left and rotate to the right. Bend to the left, rotate to the right, to the left, and to the right. Bring it to center, take your breath in and out. Let's take that over to the right and rotate to the left. Take a breath in as we bend to the left and rotate to the right. Take a breath in. So try to drop your arm down a little deeper this time and rotate a little further. Take a breath in. So we go to the left, drop that arm down if you can to your elbow and rotate. Center. Take a breath in. So go to the right and rotate. Breath in and to the left and rotate. Bring it to center, take a breath in, bring it down. Push those arms out, lift, and bring it down. Reach up, bring the arms back into cactus arms here, really open out through the chest, and again, reach up and pull it back. One more time, and pull it back, and rest. Okay, so we're going to come onto all fours now. So bring yourself around, move your cushion away, unless you want to use it for your knees. So a cat-cow flow now. So starting with a cat first of all, so take a breath in here, and then as you exhale, round the spine. And then as you inhale, drop down into cow pose. And exhale up into cat. Inhale to cow pose. Exhale into cat. And again, press and push. So one more time, and then we're going to start moving this a little more. So bring it down into cow. As you come up into cat, push up to your right side, round to the left, and then up into cow, and then up into cat to the left side, round and back. And then just bring that to your neutral position. Tuck your toes under, sit back, rock back and forth a few times as you do a little down dog flow now. So pushing up and into your down dog position. Just move side to side. You feel that body stretching, moving side to side, lifting the heels up and down. You can bend your arms a little bit, pushing through. You can drop your knees almost to touch, then lift back up. So you do whatever serves you in this position. You can reach an arm up and reach an arm up, whatever feels right for you. Press through the heels, lift up, drop the knees and hover, dip your belly and look up, and then push all the way up into down dog. Move it side to side. Take your right arm over the left and stretch, and then take your left over the right and stretch. And then release as we come down into our crocodile position. So we're going into a cobra flow here. So drop the knees, come down and lift into cobra and release down. And again, so take a breath in and lift, elbows into your side and release down. Tops of the toes down, have your feet just slightly turned in. Decompress the spine and release. So focus on peeling the anterior spine up. Go as high as you feel comfortable. No squeezing of the buttocks. Lifting up. And exhale. And again, a few more times. Lift. So feel that lovely opening of the front body. And feel the work in the back here, pushing through, shoulder blades in toward the spine, and release it down. Okay, just rest it here now as we come into our Sphinx pose. So we're just going to rest here and work the back a little bit, so rock side to side. So have your arms forwards. So the further forward your arms are, the less you're going to come up, so you find your positions right for you. Pubic bone down. Draw your forearms apart as if you're trying to split your mat apart, and then draw the shoulder blades down. Take a breath in and lift the heart center and just hold that position. Press the tops of the toes down. Allow your knees to lift up naturally and feel the work in that lower back. Take a few breaths here. Maybe deepen. Roll those shoulders back and down, away from your ears. And then release it down. So move side to side. Going to do that again. Going to come up a little higher for those that want to. So if you bring your arms back a bit so your elbows are underneath your shoulders. Shoulders back and down, same thing. Take a breath in and lift. So get a little bit more height here. And then those who can lift up onto their hands. And relax through. So use any props that you feel would be helpful to you here. So something under your belly to keep you in that position, to give you support for your back. You can use bolsters or cushions or blocks under your arms to come up a little bit higher. Okay, so if I wanted to do that, I just put my block here and lift and just relax in that position. So allow my hips to sag like a hammock. If I want to make it higher, just take my block a little higher. So whatever's right for me. Remember, the block has lots of different sides which you can come up into to develop your pose. And release it down. And just rest it down a little bit here now. Rock side to side. As we're going to come up onto our knees now, so if you want to use your support to get into that position, that's fine. So I'm going to come side face on now so you can see what I'm doing. So we're going to do a kneeling side bend to the right side. So I'm going to take your left leg out, foot forwards, hip in line with the knee here on the supporting leg. Reach up, and you can use your block if you want to here for support, and reach up, up and over, lovely stretch through that side. So whatever position is right for you. Cute. And then release, and bring it in. Okay, so we're going to come into a low crescent lunge. So I'll turn back this side again now. So I want you to have your right leg behind the leg that you were kneeling on just now. Keep it there, walk it back a little bit as we do a low crescent lunge. So have your feet wherever you feel comfortable. Take a breath in. And we're going to make this a dynamic stretch. So push forward and back a little bit. Push, exhale. So exhale here and then inhale. And then from here to exhale, come into a hamstring. So as you inhale, push forward and up. And as you exhale, drive this left hip back, this front hip back, and fold over the thigh. Inhale up. And exhale. And again. Inhale up. And exhale. So you want this lovely flow of breath with the movement stretching from one side to the other. You can bring those arms round and down and push forward and up, round and down, and again forward and up, and round and down. Okay, just relax it here. So we're coming into our low crescent twist now. So I'm just going to hold this for a little bit. So take those arms up and turn to your left. Bring your arm to the outside. Bring your palms together. I'm going to come this way so you can see what I'm doing. So I'm just taking my arms up in my low crescent lunge, twisting, bringing my arm to the front, outside of the front leg. Palms together and pushing in, so pressing my hands together, so we've got that lovely twist in this low crescent lunge position. So deepen your breath. And release slowly out of it. So we're going to do all that on the other side. So you should be on your left knee now with your right leg out. Okay, and so let's just get my knee in the right position a minute. Okay, so hip in line with the knee, and just take that right arm up and come over. So again, you can use your block to get that lovely stretch, move that leg away if you want, but try not to lose this position of your hip and your knee, okay? So stretch it out, whatever you feel comfortable. Really lengthen through the fingertips. Ground the outer edge of that straight leg. And you can have your bent knee, foot resting on the ball of the foot, or just toes flat. whatever is comfortable for you. Okay, so we're going to reach up. I'm going to come sideways into our low crescent lunge. Okay, so let's take a breath in. So push down, exhale, and again, reach and hold it there just a sec. Just feel that position here in that hip, and then push off your front foot, your front heel, and come forwards. And again, so moving nice and smooth, arms out to the side, relax it down. And again, pushing up, leaning back, if that's available to you, and reaching forwards. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. So lovely flowing breath. Movement here, going from the front of the back leg into the back of the front leg as you transition through with breath and down. And one last time. And bring it down. Okay, so we're doing that twist now, so I'm going to come back here. So in that low crescent lunge, so reaching up and then bring your arms down. So bring your elbow, if you want to, you can just use your hand, okay? And then bring your palms together and push the hands together as you look past your elbow so that you get a lovely opening and twist in this position here. So deepening the breath, just relaxing through, always searching for a little bit more space. And then releasing. Okay, so we're going into a child's pose. I'm going to make it a nice dynamic child's pose. Okay, so knees nice and wide. So sitting back, first of all, move your shoulders. And then what we're going to do to make it a dynamic one is to come back up to this position. As you sit back, you come to your right side and then up and child pose to your left side. And again, to your right side. So feel that right side stretching. Keep your hands where they are if you can, so that you really get a lovely stretch. So you're just sitting down onto that side. If you have your feet closer together, you'll feel a bit more stretch. The wider you have your knees, you'll find a bit more stretch. So just play around with that. And then this time, we're going to go to the right side. I'm going to hold it there. So sitting down on that right side, move your right hand over towards the left to increase that stretch a little bit more. Move the shoulders up and down. Search for a little bit more space. Deepen your breath. When you feel that space, just move into it, stay there. And breathe into the area of tension that you may be feeling. And then slowly release. Bring yourself to center. And just relax here. So we're going to do all that on the other side. So starting with that dynamic child's pose first of all. So coming up. And then we're going to go to the left side. Center. And to the right side. And center, and left side, be stretching up. And just make a note of how one side feels compared to the other one. And the left side, Good. Center and to the right side. We stretch it out. So slowing it down a little bit more now. Stretch. A little bit more of a hold. Come back up. Right side. A little bit more of a hold. Good. And then we're going to go to the left side and hold. So snuggle down there. Move your left hand over and move those shoulders up and down. If you feel you need to deepen into that stretch a little bit more, and then hold it and deepen your breath. Breath in, bring yourself to center and just walk yourself up and bring yourself to sitting. So we're going to do a boat flow pose now. So we're going to use a block in a minute, but we'll start first of all. So sitting, bring the flesh out from behind you and then just tuck your tailbone under and just tilt back a little bit so you feel your core kick in. So that's your easy Navasana boat pose. Draw the shoulder blades in toward the spine. So you don't want this crouched feeling here, okay? So bring it back, good posture, and just rest. You can rest your hands on your knees if you want. Just feel in that position. Lift the right leg and lower. Lift the left foot. And lower. So all the while you just hold in this central position here and lift and lower. Lift and rest. Good. Let's have a little rest around the back. So let's do that again. So tuck your tailbone under, roll through the base of the spine, lift the heart center. So this time we're going to lift the right leg, take the arms out if that's available to you. You can always have your hands down here, okay? And hold that position. Good. Then lower that foot and lift the other one. Good. So really feel this switching on here, front, back and sides, not just in your belly. Good. And rest it down and then just come back up and relax over. Take a few breaths. So we're going into our next stage of the boat pose. So tailbone, take it back, lift the heart center. Arms out, lift the right leg. So really tuck in now and lift the left leg. And those who can raise the right leg, raise the left leg. So full boat pose. Just relaxing into it. Feel the work, feel the strength. Feel everything going here. And then drop your left, drop your right, and come up and rest. Good. Just take your hands back. Let's just do some windscreen wipers side to side. Good. Okay, so I'm going to use my cushion again now. So bringing yourself into a twist position. So bring your left foot in underneath your right thigh. And then bring your right leg over. So you can stay in this position and pull across and stay in that position. So that's your first option. Okay, so those who want to can go into a deeper twist and a deeper opening for the hips. But again, people with hip replacements, you just stay in this one here. Okay, so bring that foot back, lift up, kind of cross your knees so your feet are in that position there. So we're in a revolved shoelace. So revolved shoelace I mean we're going to be down on the floor as well, but I'm just going to do it seated for those that want to do it like that. Okay, so change my mind at the last minute what I'm doing. So just feel the hips here. Feel the opening of those hips. Good. So I'm sitting on my cushion. I like to have that little bit of a lift. Not everybody's hips are the same. Some people need a little bit more lift than others. So as soon as you feel this here, if you're in this position, you feel this here. So you can hold onto your knees, take a breath in. You can reach forward if you wish and get a much deeper experience of the pose in your hips. Good. Okay, so we're going to come up out of that slowly. Bring that front leg and then bring the other leg out and then just rock your hips side to side. So we're going to do that on the other side now. So bring your right hip, your right foot underneath. Your left leg comes over the top. Make sure your foot is in line with the leg. And then you can just sit here in this position. You can add that twist here. You can go here, whatever, okay? Just stay there. So it's nice to stay there just to get hips getting used to that position first of all. And then when you're ready, move your foot, sit yourself up, cross your knees, and then sit yourself back down on your cushion. So your feet are both in that position there. And then just notice how one side feels compared to the other. So this is a lovely pose to open up tight hips. We get a lot of tight hips when we spend a lot of time sitting. And not moving very much. So, and for those of you that are new here, you're not going to be able to get into this position correctly, so please stay with that first option, okay? So there are things for people to progress into. As you loosen up your body, your mind, your breath. So yoga is about mind, body, and breath working together as one, and not just how far can I stretch, okay? Stretching is just one element, just one limb of the eight limbs of modern yoga, okay? And modern, I mean the last so many thousand years. Okay, so we're going to come from here now. So lift this leg up, carefully bring it back. Sometimes it can feel a little bit, a bit sticky when you get out of them. So we're going to come into a bridge flow now. So it's a nice flowing bridge position. So bringing yourself down, all the way down, heels into the bottom. So we're not going to spend too much time going through this. Just listen to me as I'm going through it. So shoulders back and down. So draw the heels in towards you. As you take a breath in, lift the tailbone and then feel the spine as it leaves the mat, pushing up into the top of your bridge. You can use your hands here to push up a little higher. Take a breath in, and then as you exhale, you imprint that spine all the way down till you come back to your start position. So with breath, take a breath in. As you peel the spine, you can use your hands to push it up. Still with that breath in, hold the breath in. And then exhale as you lower all the way down. And again, breath in. So a lovely flow of movement and breath. Hold the breath and exhale as you let it go. Just feel in that spine as it comes down. And again, breath in, pushing up. Use the hands, just lift up a little higher. And exhale. So we'll just do a few more here. So take a breath in, rolling up through the spine, pushing up, holding the breath, and exhale. Let's just get one more in here. So inhale, pushing up, hold the breath, and exhale, and bring it down. Okay, so we're going to stay with the bridge. We're going to add a different element now, okay? So we're going to put the right ankle on the left thigh and do exactly the same thing. So if this is too much for you, then please just do the normal bridge you've just done. So here we go. So take a breath in, lift, hold the breath, and exhale. And again, inhale, pushing up, hold, and exhale, and release. Okay, so we're going to do that on the other side. So left foot to your thigh, or just above the knee. Take a breath in, pushing up. Use your hips, really open out that left hip there. And exhale as you lower down. And again, take a breath in, pushing up. And exhale down. And last one. So inhale. Push down through the feet, draw the heel back in, pushing up, hold the breath, and exhale as you imprint the spine down, and just bring those legs in, just give them a nice little rock side to side. Good, do some circles, and when you're ready, bring yourself down into Shavasana. So whatever shape you wish to make here, just make sure it's a shape that's comfortable for you. So arms by your side, just relax down and just notice your body. Some of you may feel some tingling, some sensations of your body from the practice that you've just done. So just use this time here to look deep within yourself. How does your body feel? How does your mind feel? And how is your breath? So just consciously slow down the breath. Observe the rise and fall of the belly and the chest as the breath courses in and out the body. Visualize a bright red, colorful breath in, bringing you fresh nutrients, oxygen, fresh life. Feel it as it circulates around your body, from the top of your head to the tips of your toes. And visualize your breath out. It's a deep blue, taking away all the toxins, the waste products of your life force. Look deep within your heart. Into your chakra, your Anahata chakra. Feel the love and the kindness within your heart, which you give to others. And now give yourself your own love and kindness, gratitude for being. Deepen your breath and bring small movements to fingers and toes, wrists and ankles, head and neck, changing the direction. And then take a breath in with your feet close together. Reach up as tall as you can. And relax with a sigh as those legs come in and rock side to side. And when you feel able to, bring yourself up into a seated position, either rolling to your side or just rocking back and forth a few times to bring yourself up to a lovely seated position to end our practice with. So we'll finish where we started in butterfly. And palms facing down, having received. Bring your palms together, thumbs to your heart center. Just allow your eyes to close as you reflect on your practice this morning. What have you learned about yourself today? And where in your life can you take this forward to improve your health and well-being? We collectively give thanks for the time we've allowed ourselves today. I sincerely thank you for joining me. Namaste.